here we can see an actual full DNR rule. Before we were looking at the detection part of a rule, and I mentioned the actions. Here we're looking at a detect component and a respond component of the DNR rule. This example is actually an example that that I use myself to test the DNR rule system. And what I'm saying is, if the operator is contains, so we're saying if a value is within another value, we're looking only at new processes. The value where the path and the event we're looking at is the command line. And the value is LC tracer test, an arbitrary string. So this rule is saying if the value LC tracer test is found within any command line of any new process starting, I want to match that. The respond is doing two things. So you can see it's a list of actions. So the first action is a report, fairly straightforward. So generate a detection or an alert, and the name of that alert is going to be tracer. The second one is task. So send a command down to the agent, and that's really where the look back comes into effect. The command that we want to send down to the agent has two values. So commands can be sent as command line. In this case, we're showing it as a list, clearly a kind of tokenized list of what we want to do. We're issuing the command that's called deny tree. The deny tree says, I want you to kill not just this one process, but this one process and everything it's done under. So any other processes it has spawned. So I want to destroy the whole tree. And to do this, we have to identify what is that process we want to destroy. And we are using here a special value. So you can see we're using two angle brackets on each side. And that tells the DNR rules that this is actually a look back value. So it means take the path that is between those angle brackets and don't send that as the deny tree, parameter, but rather take this path and take the value in the incoming event, the event that we're looking at right now. Take the value that's in this position and then stamp it where this look back is. So what that means is, in this case, we're saying take the routing and then the this value that uniquely identified the event. So if I go in our event earlier, I look at the routing and then I look at this. So what happens is that this value gets extracted from the event and it gets stamped here. So when the command goes out, this is what goes out. So in this case, we're using this unique atom. So this value to tell the deny tree, this is this one process. You're not dealing with PIDs in this example, process IDs or anything like that, that can be a little bit uncertain or going by executable name, which is even worse. You're saying this very exact specific process and everything underneath. That's an example of a look back. You'll see that you'll be able to use them in kind of slightly more advanced rules where you're not just reporting a detection, but you're saying, I want to take action on this. I want maybe to go and get the file that's referenced in the event. So you could use the file path to issue a file get or log get or other commands that are like that.